nationwide. Proudly serving business owners for over 90 years. Your business is your legacy. Protecting it is ours. Hi, I'm Carlos Gill, author and entrepreneur. Before we dive into today's topic, don't forget to download the workbook. Today, I'll be speaking to you about social media marketing. In this first lesson, we'll cover tips for using LinkedIn to build your business. With over 500 million members, LinkedIn is the go-to social network for business professionals around the world. Having a defined presence on LinkedIn can be a tremendous asset for any business owner by way of new contacts, lead sources, and clients. As a small business owner, you are most likely the face of your company, both in the community and online, which is why LinkedIn is where you should aim to grow your personal brand over anywhere else. Being discovered on LinkedIn and growing your brand within your industry begins with having the right combination of keywords within sections of your profile. The first step to optimizing your LinkedIn profile is to edit the headline section by adding industry-relevant keywords that are most likely to come up in search results or be entered in the search bar. For example, in my profile, I have the keywords social media, marketing, consultant, agency, author, and speaker. Therefore, there's a high likelihood that my profile will rank high in search results if a LinkedIn user is running a search for marketing consultant or social media speaker, because I have a combination of these keywords in my headline. Also, be sure to have the closest metropolitan market near you as your city, so you will come up in search results for anyone who is seeking a service provider or business owner in that city based on the keywords in your profile and location. Once you optimize your LinkedIn profile, monitor your stats weekly to ensure that your profile is coming up in search results. To get the most out of LinkedIn, you need to be active on the platform, which requires contributing to discussions, posting original content of your own, and joining LinkedIn groups. Think of LinkedIn's professional member database similarly to a Google search. However, LinkedIn enables you to search and connect with professionals ranging by location, job title, company, and industry too. As seen in the example here, you are able to easily search for and connect with key prospects who you are looking to do business with. My recommendation is that you only invite someone to connect when you meet them in person at a Chamber of Commerce event or if you have something of value to share. Do not use LinkedIn to cold pitch your business without establishing a relationship up front first. LinkedIn groups are a quick way to expand your network. By joining an already established community of LinkedIn users, you instantly have access to thousands of group members, which either work in your industry, live and do business in your city, or share similar interests. To find groups, you can type in keywords in the search bar, such as marketing, to find groups for your industry, and search for your city to join groups which are local to where you live or do business. Local groups are often created by the Chamber of Commerce or trade association chapters. By joining local groups, you will instantly be able to connect directly with anyone in the group and expand your network with local professionals. However, keep in mind that LinkedIn is all about giving value to your network, which is why upon joining a group, you should first introduce yourself to the group members and establish upfront who you are and what you do. More importantly, let the business come to you. Now, let's put this lesson to work. For this exercise, join 25 to 30 groups, ranging from local professional associations in your city to industry-specific groups. By joining and actively participating in LinkedIn groups, you will see an immediate return with more profile views, connection requests, and potentially website visits, which will lead to new business opportunities. However, don't overwhelm yourself by joining the maximum 100 groups right away. Instead, focus on quality connections and interactions first. If you need help, refer to the notes in the workbook. When you're done, come back for the next lesson to learn how to use Facebook to grow your business. Welcome back. In this lesson, we'll be covering how to use Facebook ads to reach potential customers. Facebook is one of the most useful tools available for marketing your business. Think of your company's Facebook page similar to how you view your website. It's your social media homepage. With over 2 billion monthly active users, Facebook is a powerful marketing resource. However, on average, brand pages only receive 1% or less organic reach due to Facebook's algorithm, which favors content posted by non-business users. Facebook's robust advertising platform allows businesses to tap into Facebook's database of over 2 billion active users. Through the Facebook Ads platform, you can target specific users based on location, demographic, and interest-based data. Facebook Ads are one of the most useful tools for digital marketing. Before running an ad on Facebook, you will need to create various custom audiences. A custom audience is a specific segment of Facebook users based on data points such as age, location, gender, language, or interest that you set. Meaning, if you are a real estate agent and you want to get your content in front of first-time home buyers, you can create audiences based on the profile of your target customer. Getting organic reach on Facebook can be depressing and difficult without having the right mix of content that's favored by Facebook's algorithm. Here's what you need to know to maximize your Facebook page reach. Facebook is a business, and they want your advertising budget. If you're going to increase your reach on Facebook, you need to pay for it, which is why the algorithm prioritizes content from non-business pages, including groups. A mistake that almost every business page on Facebook makes is the engagement call to action, such as like this post or comment below. Instead, make your content so good that instinctively users will want to engage with it. For instance, a good image and short caption, maybe ask a question or lead in with emotion. Have visually appealing content that users will want to engage with and share with their friends. Last, Facebook will prioritize content that keeps users on Facebook. So begin uploading your videos directly onto your business page and only send users to your company website once they've engaged with you in the form of a comment or inbox message. A Facebook post boost is intended to drive initial post engagement needed to create momentum, whereas a campaign should try to accomplish a specific goal, such as drive leads or website clicks. Typically, a campaign will run for 30 days and incorporate several posts and content assets, whereas a boost is an ad buy for a single piece of content. Because Facebook for Business is pay to play, you will want to have an always-on ad budget, meaning set aside marketing budget for every month to run ads promoting your products or your services. An excellent entry-level budget is at least $10 per day or $100 per day for advanced sellers. Now, pause here and pull out your workbook and build out your plan for the next 30 days, including boosted posts. Next up is Instagram Stories. Now that you've learned about why social media matters for your business, let's move on to how to use Instagram Stories to grow your brand. Social media storytelling is a newer form of content marketing made popular by Snapchat and Instagram, as well as YouTube personalities. While consumers have grown tired of seeing content that appears to be an advertisement from a brand or corporation, storytelling is a tactic for individuals and corporations to be viewed as real and relatable without relying on professionally produced content. With stories, think of yourself as the star of your own reality series. The key to telling good stories in social media is less about the platform and more about the story that you're trying to convey. Because stories typically expire within 24 hours of being posted, your stories should be short, attention-grabbing, and drive users to take a specific action. As a best practice, you should storyboard your content whenever possible to have a beginning, a middle, and an end. Although Instagram limits the use of third-party tools to automate Instagram tasks, the following tactics will help you and your content stand out on the platform. First, Instagram is all about telling a story through visuals. Therefore, you should strive to create visually appealing, eye-catching content, which someone will be compelled to engage with as they scroll through their newsfeed. Similar to any social network, the lifeline of a post on Instagram is short-lived without meaningful engagement, which is why you should strive to post high-quality content. Post often enough to keep your followers engaged. If you don't post on your page daily, use stories as an alternative. Outside of your photo or video post, your post caption is intended to tell a short story to gain a like or a comment. However, keep your caption short and ask your followers what they think or how they feel to drive comment engagements. In all of your post or stories content, you can tag a location. Do this to expand your reach to those who are following the location versus your account. And if you have a website or blog, embed your Instagram content to leverage website or blog traffic. You might be successful in gaining new followers this way as well. Each Instagram post has a story on the front end through the captions, as well as behind the scenes in the metrics. Comments matter because they indicate someone left a review, feedback, or thoughts on the post. This is also an opportunity to engage back. The real magic on Instagram occurs when you build up a community. That's when you can use Instagram as a tool to sell. To generate a leads list around the launch of my book, I kept my community updated throughout the book writing process. Periodically, I used the polls feature to ask my followers if they were looking forward to reading my book. I received a lot of yes answers, and once my book went on sale, I messaged each one of these individuals with a link to where they could go to pre-order. Within your Instagram account, you can also see the number of website clicks from the URL in your profile and profile visits as a result of a post. Think of a hashtag as a category where you can go to find content that's of interest to you, such as sports, business topics, news, or insurance. All those social media hashtags were initially exclusive to Twitter. Today, all content on Twitter is searchable based on keywords in tweets. Similarly, Facebook crawls keywords in posts as well. Therefore, hashtags are not required. However, on a social network like Instagram, adding hashtags to your posts which are relevant to your content will increase the likelihood that a non-follower will see your content. To maximize your reach, you can try adding hashtags of trending topics to your content, such as hashtag your city, or, for example, if you're an insurance agent in Los Angeles, California, you would use hashtag insurance, hashtag insurance agent, hashtag insurance agent Los Angeles, and hashtag Los Angeles insurance agent. You would put these hashtags in your content. Now, pull up your workbook again and look for the Instagram exercise. Plan out your next 7 days worth of posts. On each day, publish new pieces of content on Instagram and add up to 10 hashtags, which are a combination of local and industry hashtags. And stay tuned for the next lesson, which is going to teach you how to use customer testimonials through video in your content. For our last lesson, we'll be covering how to create engaging customer testimonial videos for social media. From Instagram stories to YouTube to Facebook Live, video content helps humanize your brand and make your customers feel more connected to your company. By building rapport with your customers offline or engaging with them online, you can ask your customers to create short testimonial videos which can be shared on your social media channels as content. Whether you're a real estate agent, photographer, website developer, or a local coffee shop, maintaining an active presence on YouTube can help you gain precious website visits and drive leads as a result of the videos that you post. As an added benefit, your YouTube videos are discoverable via Google search also. Because Google owns YouTube, you have a higher likelihood of being discovered through a video that you upload to YouTube related to your topic or subject matter expertise than a traditional Google search, which crawls the entire internet. Every small business should be investing in creating video content in the coming year to humanize their brand through its people, including employees and local businesses in the community too. Ideas for types of video content to create are a Meet the Owner series, whereby the owner of a small business creates a weekly video shared on Facebook and YouTube about his or her journey to entrepreneurship, including best practices, learnings, and tips to share with aspiring entrepreneurs. Employee takeovers to shine the spotlight on your team. Product tutorials or infomercials teaching your potential customers how to use your services or products. Last, Think about creating a local business spotlight or video podcast sponsored by your company, which promotes other businesses in your city or town. On the surface, one might look at YouTube as a place to watch music videos, stream video games online, and tune in to one's favorite vlogger. However, as the second most searched site online, YouTube is an untapped goldmine for small businesses and creators to make money. And it's easy. For example, in my business as a public speaker, I use YouTube to get leads from conference organizers to book me to speak at their event because I have content of me speaking. This content is also easily discoverable when you run a search for social media keynote or social media tips, since YouTube is a search engine that is owned by Google. For your business, use YouTube to teach about how it is that you do what you do, regardless of your product or service, and ensure that your video titles have keywords, such as your industry and city, if possible. Whether you are a car dealership and want to showcase the experience of a customer driving off the lot in a brand new vehicle, a real estate agent who just helped a family purchase their dream home, or an insurance agent that just helped someone protect their future with your services, capturing testimonials are valuable for future growth and can also create evergreen content for your customers to share across their social media channels as an endorsement. As you gain reviews from customers and testimonials, start posting them to your Facebook page and YouTube channel as well. Also, go back and ask previous customers if they would be willing to record a 1-minute video using their smartphone and have them send it to you to get started right away. Congratulations, you made it to the end. Be sure to share what you learned in the comments below and come back for more episodes like this one.